For those of you who aren't familiar with Teal Swan, I'm not her biggest, like, content fan, but I sort of love that she's out there and she's putting herself out there and being, like, she's just really weird. And I think I just like that about her. But at the same time, I haven't watched enough of her content to know how much of it I actually, like, fuck with on, like, a larger spiritual level. I have a feeling I'm less woo-woo than the average woo-woo, but still pretty woo-woo, that I think it makes me feel separate from her work. What's a stream deck? Sadistic Atheist says, you need a stream deck. I don't know what that is. What is that? Tell me what it is. Okay, have you looked into Teal's controversies? If you mean the fact that she thinks she's like a star child and like sent down from the heavens to like help the world, that's the stuff that I'm just like, that is not my vibe. Isn't Teal Swan a bit mental, like done some shady shit? I think she is. Like, that's the thing. I think she is kind of crazy, which is why I can't get into her content. But at the same time, people love her. So let's go ahead and review this video. Also, I feel like my eyes keep fucking crossing. Oh my God. My eyes are having like a lot of problems today. Okay, let's ignore that. This is called The Major Misunderstanding About the Law of Attraction. And since I really don't understand the law of attraction outside of manifestation, I thought we'd watch this video. Please tell me how her volume is while I pull up Discord chat. More than kind of crazy. Yeah, I do think it's like, I don't know, the problem, we're trying to gay judge. Let us just gay judge Teal Swan today. No real judging, just gay judging.
As soon as people learn about the law of mirroring, which is often
Persephone says some call Teal Swan the suicidal cat, the suicide catalyst. What? Tell me what that means.
Called the law of attraction. They begin to ask the question, how am I a match to this? They ask this question because they start to recognize that their own consciousness, I should say the frequency of their own consciousness, is attracting in or inviting in people, places, things, and experiences that vibrate at a like frequency. It is an energetic match. They start to recognize that what is happening in the external is like a reflection of what's happening on the internal in a fractal-based universe. For example, imagine that as a child you were abandoned and the abandonment is not healed within your consciousness. That means you are still a vibrational match to abandonment later in your life. Or, for example, imagine that you are someone who does not consider other people's best interests, only your own. You will be a vibrational match to other living beings that do not consider your best interests, only their own.
This is why I don't watch Teal Swan. Her voice is so monotone that I zone out, which is probably just, I could probably take medication for it. This is not a judgment on her.
You will also see it within the spiritual communities, that when somebody is aware of the law of mirroring, the second that somebody else in their life goes through something unfavorable, they'll automatically turn to that person and say, how are you a match?
Whoa! What? By the way, you know, I think I've asked you this in the past, girl. Is it Miss Alicia or Miss Alyssa? I just realized I call you Alicia, but it could be Alyssa. Wait, is it Alicia or Alyssa? Or neither? Oh my God, girl. Apparently she encouraged people to kill themselves to reincarnate. That's so bad. That's really bad. I think that's much more unethical than telling people just to kill themselves because life is stupid. I feel like that's much more reasonably sound, like life is shitty. But like, to kill yourself in the hopes of procreation, that is bold. That is bold. Ooh, I don't like that.
To this. I want to go on record as saying that's an incredibly unattuned thing to ask somebody who is going through something difficult.
Oh, Haley says, no, no, that's wrong. She doesn't encourage people to kill, but okay. It absolutely is Alyssa, but you can call me whatever you want. Wait, it is Alyssa. Alyssa. Oh, it's Alyssa. Just like Alyssa. Now I'm saying it too many times. It doesn't sound like a real name, but I knew a girl growing up named Alyssa. She might have been the only one. So it's not, it's Miss Alyssa. Yes, Miss Alyssa. Yes? That's the whole thing. Wait, Alice says, Okay, yay, Alyssa. I'm so glad we cleared that up. Alice says, yeah, that's her whole thing. I remembered. It says suicide is a good thing. I mean, I feel like being able to kill yourself is your right, and I feel like it is a good thing to be able to have freedom. But I couldn't imagine encouraging, like, if it's so good to kill yourself because reincarnation, you first, Teal Swan!
When you ask this question, it has this connotation that as if the pain of the experience isn't bad enough, on top of it, they somehow brought it on themselves, and it is therefore their fault. But the tendency for people to ask this...
Ah, Haley, this makes much more sense. She says that killing yourself doesn't solve anything because you can't escape the pain. You will encounter it in another life again until you ascend. Ah, okay. And Mikey says she's not encouraging suicide. Okay, that makes more sense. So that doesn't actually make sense. Actually, I read that Dolores Cannon book, Five Lives Remembered, and it's about that, how if you believe in reincarnation, which I don't, but I totally vibe with the energy. Reading the book was so fun from Dolores Cannon because she was like a psychotherapist, and so she was interviewing people. It was really cool, her and her husband. And though that is prevalent, that in every life cycle, there's always going to be the hardship of life. And the hardship of existence, well, it's naturally going to be a pain you can't escape, right?
This question to other people. How are you a match to this? Actually has made me aware of something. There's a massive misunderstanding that so many people have about the law of mirroring. Let's go into it, shall we? With this idea that in order to experience...
Yo, does she look like a Bella Swan? She does, doesn't she?
Something you have to be a vibrational match to it.
She's like a Bella Swan.
This idea that the more conscious you become, the more control you can exert over your life experience. Because if you can control your personal vibration, you can therefore control the reflection that you're getting, right? Now, with this comes this idea that at some point you can reach a level of consciousness where you no longer experience
more like
any
Xena.
More unwanted
things. No, she's a tougher, topper Bella Swan, but a bottom Xena.
Things.
Or if Xena's a top Dom, then she's a top, and Bella is a bottoms from the top. Oh man, that's so good. That's funny. I could amuse myself all day with that.
If somehow the
that's
more
great.
Conscious you become, the more exempt you become from contrast. That's not how it works, you guys.
Why not?
That's actually completely false. Your relationship to the contrast changes. Essentially, people seem to think that the day will come when a person doesn't have any negative experiences, and if they do, it suggests that there's something unhealed in them or wrong with them or that they did something to...
Okay, this is really interesting because I have that issue too, where people will hear me talk and they'll say, Brittany's saying she doesn't have any bad days. I was like, no, I don't. Okay, stop. I have hard days. I don't really have bad days. I haven't had a bad day in over 3 years. And bad day to me is when I've like completely lost control. Like I've let the episode take over. I let mental health take over. But I have hard days, not bad days. So for Brittany, bad days just mean like days I've lost it. And I'm like, imagine you're like a drug addict and you have bad days as the days you relapse and hard days as the days where you just... You stay disciplined, but holy shit, the cravings are really intense. That's how I look at my life. When I'm having a craving that's really, really intense and I know it's not good for my discipline or it's not good for my joy, I call that like a hard time. But if I'm giving in to the impulse, then it's a bad day.
Bring it on. And again,
sorry, but people will hear me talk and say like, oh, Brittany's making a claim that she's like perfectly healed. It's not about that. Radical acceptance is not exactly the same thing as like being quote unquote cured, especially from something like what I have. Like I have uncurable things, right? So I can't be cured from them. I have to learn to exist with them.
Yeah.
Very different.
There's this idea that if you're conscious enough and if you control and heal and purify your vibration enough, you will no longer...
I'm so sorry. I know I'm like fucking up this video, so I'm going to rewind it a little bit. But like Discord says she's giving me Amy Lee vibes. Bro, I fuck with that.
Contrast changes. Essentially, people seem to think that the day will come when a person doesn't have any negative experiences, and if they do, it suggests that there's something unhealed in them or wrong with them or that they did something to bring it on. And again, there's this idea that if you're conscious enough and if you control and heal and purify your vibration enough, you will no longer be a match to any negative experiences, only positive ones. You need to understand that contrast will always apply to you when you make the choice to come into a time-space reality where contrast is an element.
Her language is throwing me off. Oh my god. Choice to come into a time-space reality. Play, bitch.
Where contrast is an element of that time-space reality. Contrast is the breeding ground for expansion.
Yes.
What do we mean by this?
Suffering.
By contrast, we mean wanted and unwanted, positive and negative.
Suffering.
It is in the sorting through this contrast that we desire. Desire is born from the unwanted. And desire is what propels all evolution within the greater universe. Therefore, there will not be a time where you are exempt from contrast. Any more than there will be a time where you're exempt from the process of expansion. Life would be absolutely pointless.
That's funny, because in this book, the premise of his hypothesis so far, and I'm only 50 pages in, is that because we love and because we become vulnerable, we actually ruin in some ways the longevity of romance, because the mystery brings in the passion, which people mistake for love. And romance to him is basically like chemistry, so passion, and then chaos or suffering or the point between want and not able to have is sort of like, that is the chaos that is also so lovely about existence. I actually do think that if we were given the answers in some way that like, yeah, you're gonna, like when you're gonna die or what it's gonna look like, or if we actually knew the future, we probably wouldn't stick around for as long, or maybe we would, depending on how our future was gonna go. I know some people feel like nihilism, nihilism, I was gonna like separate it into levels, but it doesn't make sense. Some people feel that nihilism, or the idea that nothing matters, is so hard for our brain to process. Even the beginning of this book, he talks about that. How the idea that we're not special snowflakes created by a god might make it so we don't want to continue existing. But I'm just like, I'm thrilled more for life knowing there's not a god, because I'm like, oh, how fun. That means like the possibilities are still endless and out there. Versus if I knew God existed, it'd be like, okay, great, now I have an answer or whatever, but it's not very interesting. Kind of ruins the mystery of it.
If you were exempt from the process of expansion, that's the whole point of life in the first place. Everything in existence has wanted and unwanted elements. Everything in existence has an upside and a downside. Everything in existence has a positive and a negative. There is contrast inherent in anything, and no matter how conscious you become, that's still going to be the case.
Mm-hmm.
At face value, the law of mirroring, what most people are calling the law of attraction, is quite simple. It's the concept of reflection, which, by the way, is an exemplary tool for self-awareness.
Hmm.
Now, given that we can simplify it in this way, you just think about it as whatever goes in front of it, you see, right? Actually, we oversimplify the law of mirroring. The reason is because people have this tendency of thinking there's only one thing that is reflecting. Let me tell you what I mean by that. A person may think the only thing that is reflecting is what they themselves are or do. When this is the case, when they say, how are you a match to this, they're implying that you are or that you do the exact same thing as the other person does in whatever scenario you are in, and are therefore getting a taste of your own medicine. Or, for example, they think that the only thing that is reflecting is childhood trauma that is still active vibrationally speaking. When this is the case, when they say, how are you a match to this? They're implying that you have an unhealed childhood trauma that is reflecting yet again in your adult life. Or, for example, they think that the only thing that is reflecting is whatever you think and believe. Therefore, when they ask you, how are you a match to this? They're implying that there is some thought you have or some belief you have that makes you a match to whatever you're experiencing. The reality is, any of these things I've just mentioned could be what is reflecting or the reason why you're a match to something. So could all of them at the same time.
I'm a very specific kind of learner. I need examples. I need examples. That's why I use my life as examples, but that's why I need examples. Like, I don't understand how you just talk this way. I understand. Like, I can read this way, but I can't think this way, if that makes sense. Where, like, you know how she hasn't given me an example? She's giving me an example, but it's not a literal example. I need a literal example. I need an example. I hope she gives me one. Okay, let me read your comments really fast. Persephone says, I think seeing suicide as a personal choice is many times wrong because most people who commit suicide because of bipolar or depressive disorders or with your... Wait. And with your information processing is impaired. So you're not making the choice with a clear mind. Yeah, the dilemma with that, though, is that if... You know, I've heard Max say this, Mr. Girl, that, like, people with borderline, like, don't deserve, like... their agency. So I don't believe in taking away agency from the mentally ill because obviously like I'm mentally ill. And so for someone to think that like they know better for Brittany than Brittany is like a lie. But I do think that there are times in my life in which I've needed help and in many ways reached out or in many ways, you know, attempted to reach out and stuff like that. The example, I'm using an example. So it's easy to say these things. And I think you're right, Persephone, for sure. But I also think what's important is that even if we can't as a society be so afraid of losing people that we take away their agency because we are afraid of losing them. People have the right to be lost, right? And so I think when people come to me and they say like, hey, I've thought about suicide. I was like, haven't we all? But no, we haven't. So I think for those of us who do struggle with it, it's necessary for us to know what kind of suicidal person we're dealing with. And not everyone is the same kind of suicidal. Not even everyone who attempts is the same kind of suicidal, right? So my concern is always about agency first because I know it's what people take away first. The thing people always take away first in the name of safety is agency, which is why I'm so protective of it.
I'm just going to give you a very short list. And when I say a very short list, I mean like a very short list.
Mikey says I should listen to Abraham Hicks. I mean, I have a little bit, but everyone has told me to listen to more. So maybe that's someone we can listen to next.
I'm going to give you a very short list of what could potentially be reflecting in the external as an experience. What could potentially make you match to something?
Let's go.
First thing, your beliefs. By the way, most of you don't even know what they are because they're so buried in the subconscious mind. That brings me to another point. What you're thinking.
She called us
not just on a conscious level, but on a subconscious level. All of that is reflecting. Your desires.
Maybe she called us a one.
Can make you a match to something. Your feelings can make you a match to something. Your resistance can make you a match to something. Unresolved traumas can make you a match to something. Positive memories can make you a match to something. Ancestral patterns can make you a match to something. Personal truths can make you a match to something. Guess what? So can lies you tell yourself and others. Also, things you are avoiding can make you...
Jan says, what are active vibrations? Am I too stupid for this? Honestly, I don't even know what that means. So, okay, I don't know about vibration talk. Like, I don't play with the woo-woo in this particular way. So, I think vibrations are energy is what I'm translating into Brittany talk. So, I... And also, this is why people think I'm Teal Swan. I totally get it. So when she says vibrations, I translate that into energy in my head. Is that correct for my vibration people in the crowd? Is vibrations energy? So when she says like high vibrations, I think she means like higher connectivity, i.e. energy sharing. Is that what that means? Right. Kenny says, I prefer your way of communicating over hers. It's easy to relate to and understand. I think that's because, I'd like to think it's because I give a lot of personal examples and a lot of like examples in general. Yes, vibration equal energy. Okay, that's about right. Okay, so vibration is energy, correct. Okay, so she's just, so we're all saying the same things. We all just use different words to say it, right? Moonlight Orange says, all I have to say, her show has a lot of crazy eye clients looking for help, troubled souls. Their eyes have no sparkle, just big eyes and dead eyes. Ooh, I want to see it. Is that the show on Hulu? One of you Snapchatted me about it. I got to watch it. Alice says, Brittany, when you say you're more aligned with existentialism, the nihilism, as in believing there's no higher power that would assign meaning, but instead assigning our own meaning to our lives. Yeah, so I think nihilism has a place in the journey of introspection. But I think if you stay there, you've made a mistake.
You match to certain experiences. Pre-birth intentions can make you a match to certain experiences. And I want to mention one last thing on this list.
You may mention
it. It should be so much longer.
Okay.
The choices that you make can make you a match to certain experiences.
So she believes in free will?
Oh, by the way, It may be of interest for you to know that in a universe that is based off of this law of mirroring, the way that divine orchestration can even occur is that it comes to you.
What is that?
And is able to reflect.
What's divine orchestration? Is that what she just said? Is divine orchestration mirroring. If I had to translate it and make an assumption, it's like a synchronicity with your life or something? Like something that's like synced up or positive?
The way that divine orchestration can even
divine
occur
orchestration?
Is so that it comes to you and is able to reflect through the reflection of your desires.
So is that like karma? Like Sadhguru says, karma is not you do good, you get good, but karma is a reflection of your life. So like the choices we make allow for the proper manifestation. Alice is just one cult leader watching another cult leader. Literally like, okay, Mikey says yes. This is what I'm saying. Like we all are saying similar things, but we use different words and different words have different connotations. Okay, let's go.
That's the open doorway for universal meddling. But the reason that your life experience being played out on this giant external screen we called life is so varied and so complicated is because there are so many things that are reflecting at one time. Potentially even so many things that are reflecting in one experience. Here's the intention. The intention for somebody who is projecting themselves into a time-space reality that is based off of the law of mirroring, meaning that they have committed to self-awareness, is a 1-2 step.
1-2
step? The one step is, I'm going to step in front of the mirror, I'm going to notice the reflection, I'm going to go into a state of pure perception. Ah, I see the reality. That's step one. Step two is, based off of seeing the reality, I'm going to give birth to what I would desire instead. And by virtue of focusing on those things, I will change the reflection in this mirror. That's step one. Step two is, based off of seeing the reality, I'm going to give birth to what I would desire instead. And by virtue of focusing on those things, I will change the reflection in this mirror. Mm. I will know whether I changed it based off of what is happening in the external environment. Mm. External. However, a lot of people are not doing this 1-2 step. In fact, in the spiritual community, you have two pretty distinct camps. You have people over here on this side that are using this law of mirroring or law of attraction to simply become aware, and then they're not really actually taking what they're becoming aware of and consciously creating. And by not doing so, they're stuck in pain and are cutting themselves off from the potential to be happy.
It's a little bit, okay, so I'm going to translate that to a little bit like nihilism. So you're going through life and you really like have that like relationship, whether you're a 2 or a 5, with nihilism where you like discover something about awareness and you're like, oh, I'm aware, but then you never do anything past that to like sort of cope with the awareness or expand upon that awareness. And so that leaves you in like this limbo space. And actually I think becomes way more torturous. Like I feel like that's a much more torturous space than moving through it. So, okay. I'm with her. The way she talks drives me crazy. I'm not going to lie. And I hate that I have to like pause to give examples of what she could mean because I feel like, I don't know. But then so here's a criticism I've gotten of my work. I share too many personal stories and I give too many examples, but I'd rather have too many examples than no examples at all. So when Teal talks, instead of having an idea of what she literally means, it allows my brain to imagine. And my imagination is going to some crazy places, girly. Is she talking about manifestation? Yeah, I think so. Like, I think this is obviously she's talking about, it sounds like the law of attraction is the form of manifestation we are exploring right now. Persephone says, is she saying people are doing the manifestation but not doing the practical work? Yeah, I think so, right? She's saying we're manifesting enough to have access to be aware of. Even the idea of manifestation is to be aware of something. But then what do you do to move forward? And then what are the consequences? Because what if you see, what if you go even beyond, I don't know. Oh, okay. Hold on. What if you go beyond that? What if you like start to orchestrate and manipulate your circumstance like she's saying to manifest this sort of goal. And then if it involves other people, right? Oh, my hair is just crazy today. I'm sorry. It's driving me nuts. The patterns are like, I can see them. And so I get distracted. Sorry. I shouldn't be looking at myself. The point is that there's like a mixture of karma being spoken about, manifestation, and like introspection, I think, is kind of what all of this is covering.
And all the way over on this side, what we have is our bypass.
Sadistic Atheist says, what product is this woman selling? She just talks a good word salad. That's the thing, though, is like, I'm like gay judging, right? So I'm trying not to real judge her. So if I'm just gay judging, she is saying the things that everyone is saying, but she's saying them in a way that's like so flowery and so poetry that it makes you feel like you're being sold to, in the same way that I think my work does. But is she like me, where she actually knows the work is meaningless in like a real way and is only helping the bubbles it interacts with? Or does she think she's like universally changing some sort of like time and space thing? That's what I can't figure out.
These are people who are completely foregoing step one. They are not looking at anything.
Amber Heard energy. They're
not looking at the reflection. It's not about that. They're going to instead ignore it all, go into a state of denial, and then say, you know what? I can create whatever reflection I want to create. It's not about self-awareness. It's not about awareness at all. It's just about creation. And therefore, I am going to focus on what I want to have be true and watch the reflection change as a result of this. Why is this so dangerous? Because with the awareness, you create drastically different things. Okay, so that was my soapbox moment.
Yeah, wait, yeah.
Sorry, you guys. That was my soapbox moment about the fact that...
So the more introspective you are, the different your outcome will be. Okay. Love that. Yes. Anyway, we can manifest some more of the titties. Titles? Titties. Titles. Titties? I mean, how much more do you need? Titties. She needs to look inward. So do you think that she's just experiencing her relationship with existence or with existing? Also, how did I lose my fucking chat? Here it is. Found you guys. Okay. She's selling spirituality and people are out to get her. I think because they don't want her to become powerful like the church she's holding. She is holding like a cult, spiritual cult in Costa Rica. Oh, okay. I joke about having a cult. And don't get me wrong. I want to have a meditation center one day. It's like a camping center. But in general, like I actually don't want to have like members. Like I don't want to have like a following that's like, we have to be with Brittany Simon, like in the rich, like, okay, calm down. I just want to be a homie that hangs out and smokes with my homies. Right. And we talk about introspection and philosophy. So it's basically like an atheist convention in the woods. Do you know what I'm saying? Like, it's basically like just a convention in the woods, like Comic-Con, but in the woods. But is Teal saying that she, that's what I mean. I feel like Teal's a two who's packaged her belief in a way where she wants other people to really believe it. But is that wrong? A lot of spiritual practices, cults are in Costa Rica. Really? Why? Why? I'm so curious. Miss Alyssa says, does anyone ever think about manifestation being an illusion? Like a linear time is an illusion? Like are we not manifesting what we want, but rather practicing what it would be? Yes. So I think like manifestation, like if you read The Secret, which I read when I was like 19, so I don't really even remember it, but it is about manifestation. But I think some people, like Trisha Paytas, rely way too heavily on the I really want it thoughts versus the actively going for it thoughts. And then here's the thing. Manifestation is a form of fantasy where you can manifest all day in your home. I hope I'm rich. But what you're not understanding is that if that manifestation ever came true, which would take hard work, which would actually lend you to being responsible, right? So what happens is that people manifest without action because they don't actually want it. Or they don't actually need it. If they needed it, I think that it would probably follow through, or if they wanted it, it would follow through from manifestation to action, which would bring result. But manifestation from the house is just like a really good placebo effect and probably feels really nice. I really hope this thing happens. I really want to imagine I'm blah, 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 blah. It's like you can come up with whatever idea you want. But I feel like what she's trying to say is that manifestation plus action equals results.
But there are these two distinct camps that are forming within communities.
hold on. Which manifestation is like the woo-woo word. I think if you weren't woo-woo, you just say, hey, deciding what I want, creating the plan to get it, and executing plan. Do you know what I mean?
These that are aware of the law of mirroring. And we really need to get rid of these camps and really recognize that the law of mirroring was meant to put those who are part of this construct in a 1-2-step type of experience. All this being said, there's something that you need to accept, and I mean powerfully, once you have already accepted that there is contrast inherent in anything. And that's that the choices you make, whether those choices are conscious or subconscious, will line you up with specific unwanted and wanted experiences. There's contrast that's going to come with any choice you make. And oftentimes the only way to guarantee that you will not experience a certain unwanted thing or a certain type of contrast is to make a different choice altogether. And this is something that a lot of people are not seeing when it comes to the law of mirroring. For example, making the decision to participate in life on planet Earth, you are going to experience gravity. Or, for example, making the choice to be a surfer means you are going to get cold and wet. Or, for example, making the choice to be in the public eye means you will experience projection, be critiqued, and be judged. Or, for example, making the choice to be a parent means you are going to experience the pressure of the well-being of another life depending on you. Now, using...
Sorry, I want to read this chat before I get too far behind because I'm losing you guys already. Haley says, I just don't really understand why people hate her. Just don't buy her product. She created a bubble and she sells it for a living. Yeah. Obviously, like, if you're talking about Teal, obviously, like, treat her how you would treat me or anyone else. Like, she's just a person doing her thing. I have no problem with her beliefs either. Like, I don't know how she's any different than any other religion or spiritual belief. She's obviously helping people. She has quite a good following. She's over 1 million subs, bros. And she does her retreats. So she's really just living like a really good life, right? So I don't have an issue with Teal at all. I think that what's important is that we're examining the bubble she's in and how she operates within it, what bubble I'm in and how I operate within it. So I know a lot of people associate me with Teal Swan and Shaylin Lester, but I don't like Teal or Shaylin. I have to... Shaylin? Uh-oh, now I don't know anyone's names. But that Lester lady, her too, it's the same thing. When I hear them talk, I just kind of like, I couldn't watch this on my own. But I don't really think she's saying anything that's wrong either. Like, that's the thing. Is she actually saying anything wrong? Cassandra says, your hair looks so vibrant today. Thank you. I washed it. I feel like it's, like, very awake today. Melissa says, does anyone ever think of manifestation as an illusion? Which I read before. I think manifestation, and then Discord in conjunction with that thought, Discord said manifestation is for people who need to feel like they're special in order to do stuff. I think so, maybe. But, you know, I was just talking about how with Taylor Yoga, we do yoga on our Discord twice a month. And she's amazing and she does it because that's her profession. And I told her yesterday that the meditation for yoga, it was like there was one point during the yoga, guys, where I felt like my body was in this position and I felt like my whole body was like dried scales, like dragon scales. And then she said to like, she used like really woo-woo language and she was like something like breathe it in to the tip of your toes or something. And when I breathed in all that air, I felt like the scales were like flying off my skin. Throughout the whole time we do yoga, she talks to us and she uses like really woo-woo language, but it is extremely helpful. So then we talked, we had such a great call today. And today we talked about how adults somewhat have to play pretend to sort of do the things that are silly. Like during the yoga thing, she's like, shake your head, nod it up and down. She's like, move your jaw. She's like, I know you've been probably clenching your jaw, so like move it around. And it feels really silly. Like you feel silly, but in order to release the tension, you have to feel silly. So it looks like you're LARPing some version of pretend, like BDSM or anything related to that, even yoga. It's like a form of almost like performativeness that you need to kind of click in your brain that you're doing something special. I think that's why people look at tarot. I think it's why people use the word manifest. But I totally get it and I'm fine with it. If it motivates you to move forward, I don't think that's the issue. I think the issue is, have we become crutches Or have they become crutches to us? And I think a lot of 2C, 2Bs can fall into the problem of, like, believing to such a point that, God forbid, if they find out it's not true, it could shatter their life again and they'd have to start all over. Versus I'm trying to get you guys to a point where you're allowed and given permission to take on these belief systems without the objective nature or subjective nature of them not existing. Let's say they're not objective. I don't want that to shatter you again, so you have to fucking start all over. I want to get you guys to a point, whether you, I mean, you don't have to, obviously, but like to the point where, you know, you are existing, you're examining, you're comfortable, you hold beliefs, but your whole world's not going to be shattered if those beliefs end up becoming shattered. And that's a pretty big ask, but I think given the reason you guys are here, probably will work for most of you. And I think you'll be healthier down the road. So does Teal, so you guys can correct me, does Teal believe, like, if Teal's ideas are shattered in front of her, will it destroy her? Or is she aware that her ideas are shatterable? If that makes sense. Okay, let me go back to these chatters. Rice Bowl says, I think you and Teal are in a really similar bubble, which is why the series hits so weird. She said she doesn't have the objective truth and she believes in bubbles and talks about them a lot. See? Interesting. Inferno says, I think she's aware. Interesting.
Our analogy, I'm not saying that if you are a surfer, you should realize that choosing to be a surfer means you're just going to be cold and wet, and you should just accept that, and that's just the way it is. No. In fact, so often, the expansion that occurs within a being happens as a result of them powerfully facing whatever contrast is inevitable as a result of the choice they're making, and then working within that parameter to create
Sorry, should we watch a Shaylin Lester, is that her name? Should we watch a Shaylin video too? Do you guys have a recommendation for the one you like the best? You can either share it in the Discord live chat stream or Google something. And that way we can look her up. Because now I kind of want to compare them now that we're live comparing to her, you know?
Improvements to that contrast. How do we know this? Surfers now have wetsuits. But sticking with this analogy, no surfer should get cold and wet and ask themselves, how am I a match to this? You're a match to it because you chose to be a surfer. I mean, do you see the cruelty of it being expected that they could, if their vibration was high enough, still surf, but not get wet and cold? If this person decides they do not want to be wet or cold at all, it isn't going to work to try to work on thoughts or beliefs or feelings or trauma or whatever so as to be able to surf and not get wet or cold, they must make the choice to no longer be a surfer. To understand more about this, watch my video titled, Why You Should Consciously Choose Consequences. All this being said, it is important to understand what so many people do not understand about the law of mirroring, often called the law of attraction. And it is that part of what is lining you up with these unwanted experiences is the choices that you are making.
I mean,
choices that imply a certain type of contrast, a certain type of wanted and also unwanted experience. It would benefit.
I don't hate what she's saying, actually. I think what she's saying makes a lot of fucking sense. Discord says, I prefer using woo-woo language. It sounds more fun than saying something like set some goals, which sounds so boring. That's what I'm saying. Like, I think there's a part of her that sounds really, like, it all sounds really based, as the kids would say. Is she just talking about co-creating your reality? Maybe, Maiden. Like, I think so. I think she's just using words like vibrate. Like, I don't use words like, I use words like vibes. Like, mostly, that's the problem, is a lot of my language is internet jokes. So you know how Erudite was saying, like, I don't live on the internet as much as other people, which is true. Like, I'm not on Reddit. Like, I don't do those things. I don't know. I just learned what based was. Like, I don't keep up. But my language is still pretty internet. Like, I say vibes. I say, like, based. I say fire. Like, I say things that I learned from the internet. But I probably wouldn't. But I also do it in like a half joke, kind of like Cody Cole and Noel, where like they'll half joke about something like this. And then all of a sudden they're doing it for real. And you're like, oh, damn. I'm like at it. So I'm, when she talks, sometimes a part of me, I'm sure that's what other people hear when they hear me talk, where I say bubbles. And they're like, stop saying bubbles. Just say culture or community. But if you say community or culture or ideology, people zone out. If you say bubbles, people get uncomfortable and they start to listen. So I wonder if both Teal and I are doing the same thing, where we are trying to make people uncomfortable so they can actually hear us. Is that what's happening?
Get you to sort through any of these things, which might be reflecting in the external as this type of experience that you're having. Whatever might be making you a match to the person, people, places, and experiences that you are having. But don't forget to consciously consider what you are experiencing simply because you have made a choice for a specific thing, and that comes with specific set contrast.
Yeah, totally, totally. Bryson says, yeah, she sounds like Q. She gives me Q vibes. It's interesting. I feel like they have similar cadences or whatever. Yeah, like that's actually, Q has said that before in the past. Q's my bestie, QOT. And Q said this in the past where he's like, I actually like the way she talks. She talks, I think she talks like him too with the same, but that's why Q and I often, I'm like, describe that differently. Like, describe it differently. Because I'm very, I think I'm very theatrical and I'm very gay and imagery based. And I need like the show. I need the whole performance to understand why we're doing anything. But she speaks very like almost like matter of factly, but with woo language. And so it throws me off versus I feel like I speak. I don't know. It's like it's not a judgment. It's no judgment. I'm so fascinated by how different she is, but how I'm like, I'm vibing with what she's saying. If you translate what she's saying, even Jordan Peterson could like it. Anyone who knew Teal reminds me of Jordan Peterson. Yeah. Teal and Jordan Peterson are very similar in a lot of ways. He's more theatrical and a big baby, but that's fine.
And don't forget, if you're in one of these situations where a choice you have made makes you a match to a certain set type of unwanted experience, oftentimes the only way to not experience that is to make a different life choice entirely. Have a good week.
Thanks. Hold on. She looks like a fairy elf right there.
If you liked this video, be sure to hit the like button. Subscribe to my channel and consider sharing this video with your friends.
Yeah, I don't think I'm ever going to be adult enough to do things like that on stage. It looks really grown up. I just kind of want to have like a bonfire more and pass a joint around. Okay, let's see. Okay, let's go to the Shaylin Lester videos you guys are suggesting in Discord. This one looks like a good one. Thank you, Discord. And then we will have some fun examining.